Hello and welcome to episode 42 of Pentagon for Gold. We are now moving into our second season, or our first full season, with Santos Laguna. Having come third in the Clausura last season, unfortunately we didn't get very far in the playoffs. We got knocked out in the quarterfinals by Cruz Azul. I don't know who won in the end, but I'm not too fussed. It doesn't really affect us in the end. So, as a result of the disappointing ending to that season, where all we needed was either not to concede that that extra goal or just to score once more, we've had quite a lot of transfers happening. So because of the club vision, which says we need to sign Ecuadorian players or sign Uruguayan players, it slightly reduced the pool of players I could actually get. I only managed to get one non-Uruguayan player. And he was Peruvian, but looked very good. I did actually manage to get a Mexican or two as well, but I think they would have struggled if they'd not let me do that. Ecuadorians, there's just no point whatsoever, because either they don't want to come because they're too good, or they're not good enough. So makes it a little bit difficult to pick those up. And there's not very many of them anyway, because the Ecuadorian clubs don't really have any players coming through every time. There's no young ones, at least. So not really worth going for, so I had to get a lot of Uruguayans. And so here we go. If we have a look at our transfer history, as you can see, it's been quite a busy window. So I don't know if we had any from beforehand. No, so that's all the ins we had, and those are all the outs we had. So yeah, everything was made in this part of the season. So we sold Facundo Bello to Pumas. He was 3.5-star for us. He was never great when we played with him. He got a 6.81, which is okay, but wasn't particularly amazing. And just didn't think he was really worth keeping around for when we could sell him for that money. Lucas Blondel, who was never really good enough and is really old, so he's only getting worse. He is left on a free. And then Scalvini, I offered out in the end because he was a backup option, and I thought I could probably get better for that amount of money. So he has now gone, and he went to Tigres for 3.4 million. So the incoming is Daniel Zubiate. He's the one who was not Uruguayan. So he's Peruvian, 3.5-star with 4.5-star potential, very fast, good work rate, decent dribbling, not great finishing, but overall he's a good player. And I think he was initially 4-star when he came in. He'll probably get back up there if he gets into good form. But he looks like a good little player, and he was the best player in Peru that was available. Then we got Juan Mercado, who is a box-to-box midfielder, or technically a central midfielder, but I'm playing him as a box-to-box. Amazing passing, really good determination and stamina, very good first touch, tackling, all of that. So he's a really good option. He's come in as a 4-star player with 5-star potential. I don't know if he's improved by a slight amount rather than a lot, which is a shame, but he's definitely a high level player for this league. So that's a really good signing, I think. Then we got Antonio Camarena, who came in from Chelsea on a free. He looks pretty decent. He scored 4 goals in his first 2 non-competitive games, one of them coming on as a sub, and he's got really, really good off the ball and heading. Unfortunately, he's only got 8 jumping reach, so the heading is probably not going to come in handy very often, but, you know. So I reckon 16 anticipation, 14 composure, and 17 off the ball will do him really nicely. He's also got good technique, reasonably fast, and decent finishing, so I reckon he can bang in the goals for us. He never actually played for Chelsea, incidentally, but he clearly just came in as a cheap option, and then eventually they released him on a free. Then we have Edson Mora. He's a 2-star left-back. Not quite as good as I thought he was when he came in. He's got very good tackling, but aside from that, he doesn't look amazing. He is more of a defensive-minded fullback, but I would probably be playing him as a wing-back. He's a third choice, so I just thought I might as well get him in, since I was losing. I think it was Rojas was the left-back I had, and I actually released him on a free in the end because he kept turning down moves elsewhere. And yeah, he just wasn't really helping anyone. Then we got Emiliano Benitez. I'm quite excited about this guy. He's 18. He was in the top 11 for the Uruguayan league. Very good technique, incidentally. 20 bravery, 17 jumping reach, 13 heading, 14 tackling, 6'2", and he's left-footed. So he's going to be a really good option to have alongside Lara. And yeah, he looks really good, and also he suited the club vision of signing Uruguayan players. I still needed to get one more Uruguayan player in, so I went for Sebastian Barbosa, who had interest from, I think it was Sevilla and Lyon, so clearly there must be a player in there. I don't know how much it says he's going to improve. Could improve a lot, so yes, that stacks up given they were interested. He's going to be playing as a Mazzala, so he looks pretty good. Good first touch, good dribbling, good finishing from Mazzala. 16 acceleration, 14 pace, 15 off the ball and technique. So I reckon there's a good player in there. And yeah, so that's all the transfer business we've done. And if we have a look at the Apertura, some teams have played already. We haven't. Today we play against, who is it, Puebla, who I reckon we should be beating. Let's see where they predicted to finish 13th. So they're actually sitting in the position they're expected to be. But yes, so we'll head into that game and hopefully get a good win to start off our season very nicely. The first 11 of the season sees us play with Benitez, Zubiarte and Camarena in the starting lineup, along with Juan Mercado as our four signings that are going straight into that lineup. That means that Mercado plays as a Mazzala today with Jorge Ramirez as the box-to-box. And on the bench, we haven't got any signings there, I don't believe, but actually Edson Mora there. He's just there because our second choice left back is injured at the moment. Cantu, who, yeah, he's been injured for most of the summer, I think. So he'll be taking a little time to come back, but he's almost ready. And yeah, so let's head into this new season full of positivity, looking to get a really good start. And that's the first chance for Puebla, with Ripken heading it over. Nothing too dangerous there. Zubiarte now takes the corner, sends it in, and Ramirez has headed it over. I still need to update all the corner instructions because I don't actually have any on at the moment, which probably isn't the best idea. But here we go with a free kick from Mercado. Can he make himself an instant hero? He can. What a way to start. Cracking free kick from him. That's how you get the fans on side. Great goal from him. What are his free kicks? 11 free kick taking. Didn't look like it was that low. He's not the most flairful player, so perhaps Mazzala isn't the best position for him, but he's started well. And here's Lopez into Ramirez. Zubiarte now. Looked dangerous so far. Chips it in, and it's eventually headed out, but Nunez now picks up the pieces, and Ramirez finds Camarena, and there's his first goal as well. The new signings are settling in instantly. Wonderful news. Camarena is not likely to have too many issues settling in because he is Mexican, so he doesn't have to get over the nationality, like being in a new nation. But I mean, most of the signings we have already speak Spanish, so that should help them. It's just the way this save is at this point when we're in Mexico. It's really difficult to sign anyone that's not in in America, whether north or south. Tried going for some South Africans, they had no interest. And I think I'd have to be at someone like America to tempt non-South Americans or North Americans to come to the club. Also, because we aren't in the CONCACAF Champions League, there are a few people that weren't interested in joining as a result of that. But hopefully, we can get into it this season and strengthen the first team squad even more next season. But I do have a feeling that club culture is going to prove a pain to actually achieve, because there just aren't enough Ecuadorians that are good. And Uruguay is probably it's the least interesting out of the options in South America, apart from maybe Chile. When you compare it to Colombia and Brazil and who's the other club? Argentina. All of those nations, that it's not quite on the same level, but you know, there's still a couple of players in each season that should be of interest to us. And that was not great defending. We have now had a goal pulled back against us. 2-1. Zubiarte with the free kick. And he sends it in. Ramirez is there. Ooh, just floated wide. That's unlucky. And that's going to be another free kick for Zubiate to take. Junko looks to be in trouble with a yellow card. Referee almost went over as though he was giving him a red, but in the end he didn't. Would have been very harsh. And Lara's put it home. Assist from Daniel Zubiate. This has been really promising. If we can be this clinical, I mean, obviously we've had a lot of shots, but we are outperforming our expected goals still, so that's really good. Let's get. Who needs to come on? I think we'll get Zubiate off for Meza. Medeiros can come on for Chan. And perhaps we should give Edson Mora a run out. Give him his first start of the season. He probably won't get many opportunities, so I might as well give it to him while he's actually able to fit into the team due to Cantu's injury. Mercado and Ramirez both quite tired in central midfield, but nothing to worry about. It's quite late on in the game, so I'm sure they'll be fine. And there we go. Really promising 3-1 victory on the first day of the season. Good performances from all the new boys, really. I didn't notice Benitez too much, but that's probably a good thing given he's a centre back. And yeah, Lara is he's the one who scored in the air, so we're currently sitting in third place where we were last season, and our next game is against Cancun, who are sitting in sixth but are one of the worst teams in the division. Due to the cup game in midweek, we are going to be playing with a pretty, really rotated team, to be honest. I think Emiliano Benitez is the only one who actually keeps his place in the starting lineup today, along with Kevin Humala, who we never really need to sub out because he's a goalkeeper. So, supposedly we're the underdogs against Cancun. It's a bit surprising to me. But I guess we'll see how it goes. Maybe I've underestimated them by putting our weakest team out. But I think we still should be able to beat them with this squad. It's mostly the same squad as we had last year. A few players who are on fitness tests, so we'll probably need to make a few subs midway through. Most likely Sebastian Barbosa and Noe Kantu. Barbosa with the corner sends it in, and it's made its way out to Medeiros, who now has four men running towards him, but he's kept it there. And Sosa, oh, that's a wonderful finish from Sosa. Weak foot volley. Just leapt into the air and smashed it home off the post. It's a really nice goal. I want to watch that one again. Medeiros did really well to keep hold of the ball, and then, well, across. Guerra with a good bit of play, and Sosa just got the right sort of finish on it. No chance for the keeper. And that's a good start from this backup 11. Presumably we'll be near the top right now, second place as it stands. America losing to Necaxa 1-0. Barbosa finds Mejia. And Sosa again. Ooh, this time it's saved onto the post and away from goal. Decent attempt though. Oh, and that's a good bit of play into Benitez, but it's the stop by Geddes. Really nice corner of technique there though. And there's the confirmation of that goal for Necaxa, but now America have equalised. I'd imagine America will be back up there as one of the best teams in the division for this Apertura, I think, because they'd won the Apertura last time. They didn't really bother too much in the Clausura, probably just a bit complacent. It's a bit of a weird one, because once you've won that, there's not all that much incentive to keep going, because I guess you can win on average points, but beyond that, it's a bit of a weird system. Anyway, Benitez finds Navarez, starting an unfamiliar centre-back role. Medeiros finds Valdez. Looks to beat his man. He sent an odd ball back, but Mejia has managed to pick up the pieces there. And now Cantu finds Sosa again, and probably should have done a better finish on that one. Cantu definitely looking a little bit worse for wear, so he'll be coming off soon. Now is the time to get him off. I think it was about 60 minutes he was able to play. So Edson Mora comes on in his place. And I think Sebastian Barbosa probably needs to come off too. Get Jan Parra on for some minutes. We've restricted them to just one shot now. And that's only just happened. So a promising performance. And Sosa seems to have picked up some kind of injury. So we'll get Meza on. He can get some minutes on under his belt again. not enough to get into shape. I'd imagine 15 minutes probably doesn't get him out of the red, but certainly it's still beneficial for him to get those minutes. And unless something drastic happens, we've won. Awesome. With that backup 11, that's pretty good. I will take a 1-0 victory, even though it's only against Cancun, who are one of the weaker teams in the division. Playing your entire backup 11, really, at least where possible. Morones was injured, so we had to play Benitez. Aside from that, we did a good job. And so only Tigres and America are ahead of us in the league at the moment. Tigres eventually came back to win 3-1 against Necaxa. So how long are you out for? 4 to 7 days, nothing major. And Barbosa makes his Santos Laguna debut, as well as Mejia, actually, who was out on loan. I didn't really see why we'd signed him. Doesn't seem amazing, but he's okay. So yeah, financially we've not got a lot, whole lot left. We've got a decent wage budget of 23k, so we'll have a look later on in the year to see if there are any players with an expiring contract coming up, and as that would be a good way to get someone good in, perhaps a bit like who was it? It was Camarena coming in from Chelsea on a free. The likes of those, you know, the Mexican players that have gone to big clubs but are never really playing. So yeah, we've had a good episode today, sitting in third place, two good wins, one against Cancun and one against Puebla. So we've got the Copa MX next against Chivas, as well as Irapuato, who I don't think will prove too much of a challenge, but we'll probably come back towards the end of the Apertura. Perhaps even just for the last two games, we'll see. It's a bit of a weird system because it's broken up into two distinct sections. I don't think we'll spend too long in the seasons on this. Maybe I'll come back for Atlas and Toluca or something. But in the meantime, I hope you've enjoyed the episode. So please do leave a like and subscribe to the channels. It really helps me out. And I hope to see you next time. But in the meantime, have a great day.